I asked you all down here because we found another murder had been committed here. He's a man I think you all know. Pedro Dominguez.
Pedro killed?
Yeah, don't you read the papers?
I was in the jug.
What do you know about him?
Nothing. I only saw him a couple of times when I went to pay my rent.
What about you? You're in and out of here. You must have known him.
Sure I know him. So what?
And you?
I never been in this house before.
You?
I have nothing to do with it. I'm here to attend Mrs. Landis.
You're here to answer questions that you know.
No.
You knew him, Mrs. Landis.
I knew him? Yes, you remember him, Selma. He used to be our gardener at Ross. David, you remember him?
What, was he the man with the long white mustache?
Yeah, what did you know about him?
Well, nothing. That was 6 years ago. I haven't seen him since.
What about you?
I can't see what possible connection this can have with us.
You don't, eh? Well, I'll tell you. Pedro and Robert Landis were both shot with the same gun. Now, there was some monkey business going on down here that we want to find out about. You tell him, Mr. Charles.
Yes, with pleasure. It seems that 1 week ago, Pedro rented this apartment to someone calling himself or herself Anderson. Did you ever see this Anderson?
No.
Ever hear him up here above you?
No.
And I thought not. He was rather clever and ingenious, this Anderson. Always wore gloves, never left fingerprint. He intended, with the aid of this ladder, crawl down into your place some night and polish Robert off with this. Then he was going to climb back up here, unscrew the ladder, throw it out the window on a dump heap down below, then walk quietly out, leaving you hold the bag for Robert's murder. Now, do you know anyone who thinks enough of you to do that?
Why, no.
You're a dancer's girl, aren't you?
I work for him.
That's not what he asked you.
Well, we got an understanding.
Did Dancer know that you were going away with Robert?
Why?
Go on, go on. You told us before.
You promised you'd keep that a secret. I'll never trust a cop again.
Now, listen. If you've made the dicker with the cops, okay. But that ladder stuff is a lot of malarkey. No one did come down that ladder. And Landis wasn't killed in her place.
The only reason he wasn't killed in her place was that Anderson was found out. Pedro came in here yesterday to lay a new rug. He didn't like the looks of things, so he changed the lock on the door. When Anderson came in, he found that he was locked out. Then he heard Pedro telephoning me downstairs, and he shot him.
So what?
So, who is Anderson?
I'll bite who?
Polly, Phil had a key to your apartment, hadn't he?
Yeah.
And so had Dancer?
Yeah.
What about Lum?
No, of course not.
Anybody else?
Nobody. Say, what do you think I do, go around stuffing them under doors?
He's trying to hang this murder on us to protect his family. If the janitor didn't think everything was on the up and up, why don't he call the cops? Why does he call you? Because it's a family affair. She locked her husband off. Everyone knows that.
I didn't.
Oh, yes, you did. And then you got that lug to throw away your gun.
It doesn't
throw.
That's
a lie.
Now, Mrs. Landis.
Mrs. Landis, you knew your husband and Polly were friends, didn't you?
No.
But you knew there was a woman.
Yes.
And you knew this Pedro.
Now, Lieutenant, suppose we take up this check business.
Wait a minute. Who's doing this, you or me?
Well, that certainly never has been my party.
Maybe this guy is right. How do I know? Were you ever in this room before?
No.
What about you?
Why, of course not. What do you say?
I'll tell you what I think. She had this room and you know about it. You knew she was going to kill her husband and you had this Dr. Kammer here all ready for the nut alibi.
I attended Mrs. Landis just to make sure that she did not do anything desperate. Mrs. Landis's mind is not balanced.
Now, that isn't true. There's nothing the matter with her. It's you. You're trying to drive her crazy.
There's another mental case right there.
Darling, you have the nicest relative and friend.
Mr. Charles, don't walk off and leave me with this punch. I wouldn't have said what I had if I hadn't been a little bit punchy. This gang has got me nuts.
Oh, go on, Nicky. It's just getting good.
Atta girl.
All right, darling. Let me know when you've had enough.